choosing people to wait on the table, as we read in Acts chapter 6, you know, they were serving food, maybe preparing food or serving food for the widows. See, you are cooking food for a group of women who were doing cooking, and now they have become widows. They started complaining. And then the apostle said, choose some persons who are half wisdom and half faith. No, full of spirit. Somehow only half spirit, you know. Their bottle or their life is not filled. So that we may appoint these persons for such service. Okay. Waiting on the table, working with hands. Another word is used for those who are working in the canoe or boat. Not boat, not motor boat. They were washing or cleaning. It is just like the private bus in Kerala. We call kli or the cleaner. Instead of cleaner, so those who did not know Malayalam, what did they address them, call them? Not cleaner. Cleaner is the one who cleans, but they called him kli. Kli means any time they can fly away. Assisting. They were serving. So ministry, this is working with hands. Service. We are called for ministry. What type of work? Jesus also has mentioned in this context concerning the ministry. You read Gospel of John chapter 6 verses 26 through 29. So keep these verses in mind, even though I may not give all the explanations. John chapter 6 verses 26 through 29. Yeah, one of you read. See, even though I am the teacher, we are studying together. So usually what does the teacher ask the student? Read it. Okay? Read it. Okay, one of you read. Then? Do not work for the food that perishes. See, ministry in Kerala or in India we call external affairs ministry. Is it not? Home ministry, then foreign affairs, different ministries. Okay? What is the ministry you are in? Home ministry or foreign affairs? What is the ministry? What is the secular meaning? It is a service. We call government servant. Is it not? It is a ministry. Do not work for a food which perishes. So, what is the primary purpose of all the training in the secular or in the non, I would say, church world? For the food. Okay? You have to make a livelihood. Make some money. Have some food. Have a family. Buy a home and live there. People were looking after Jesus not because they were satisfied with the spiritual food, but they want to again get food. And what does Jesus say? Do not work for the perishing food or perishing meal, but next. Yeah. Life. So it is a work. It is a meat that will last to eternity. Then.
Which the Son of Man shall give unto you. For him hath God the Father sealed. Then said they unto him, what shall we do?
The disciples were asking the questions. What shall we do to do the work of God? What shall we do? You can highlight it or write it down. What shall we do to do the work of God? So, all the work, the main purpose of this work is what? To make a livelihood. But what shall we do to do the work of God? Then Jesus replied, believe in him. So what was the work Jesus was doing? Before that, no, Jesus walked on the water. He was feeding the 5,000 or plus persons with how many loaves? Handful of bread, loaves, or chapati, or kubus in the Persian context. Handful of loaves and few fishes. And then they saw the miracles that was performed by Jesus. What work is it? It is the work of God. Only God can do it. God can give you the seed, you can make the wheat or the flour and make bread. But who gives the wheat? Only God can produce it, no matter what happens. Can anybody walk on the water by feet? You can travel on a ship. What about healing? These were what? Supernatural work. So these disciples, common people, what was the work they were doing? They were fishermen, most of them. Is it not? And one was a politician, Simon the Zealot. I don't know what is the area of work all of you are doing, except Johnson. You are involved in different works. I don't know whether any politicians among the students, you know. I don't know. But there was one student. He was known as Simon the Zealot. And then there was one, I think, who knew little accountancy. That was Matthai or Matthew. And then Judas Iscariot. Disciples, what shall we do to do the work of God? So ministry, whatever job or whatever your hand finds to do, do it with all your strength. All the people who were involved, who were recruited, or who were called for the ministry, they were not lazy people. They were diligent. They were industrious. They were people who were involved in certain types of work. So, each and every believer who has become a child of God, when I say believer, believer in Jesus Christ is entrusted with a responsibility. What is the responsibility? There is a ministry. So, the disciples asked, what shall we do to do the works of God? I would say, before giving challenges, preparation for the ministry, that is important. See, many of the challenges come because many are not prepared. You look each and every person, even in the secular work, you need preparation. In the Old Testament time, anybody cannot go into the ministry. Hebrews chapter 5, verses 4 and 5. Preparation for the ministry, there should be a call from God. Epistle to Hebrews chapter 5, verses 4 and 5. And no man takes this honor unto himself, except he that is called of God, as was Aaron. Then, verse 5, so also Christ glorified not himself to be made a high priest, but he that said unto him, you are my son, today I have begotten thee. Okay, there are self-styled workers. There are, I could say, self-styled pastors, self-styled Christian ministers. They say, we are apostles. Who appointed you? In the Old Testament, only a person who was called by God could enter into this. Remember, God has called you. Each and every one of you, God calls people in different ways, in different times, different circumstances. So first of all, many of the challenges you see, ministry, what type of a ministry, that we will come across, but call of God is important, preparation. Okay, how many years Jesus was here on earth before he entered the ministry? 30 years. Usually in the Old Testament times, in some respect, you know, a person should be mature. Okay? Levites or priests enter the ministry of age. If some of you were in the category or in a high rank like Jesus, the Son of God, at the age of 12, when he was debating with the scribes in the temple, he overpowered them. He defeated them. If in a Pentecostal or the ecclesiastical circles, if you come across a boy 12 years of age, excel in his wit and wisdom and word, what the people will do? Yeah? Dr. Vijay and myself, we were together for the peace in NAC, and I think they may invite that boy for the conference and the guest speaker. Don't you think, Vijay? Yeah. So they may say this is a miracle boy, miracle preacher. Jesus waited. Preparation. Long time preparation. Until the age of 30, he had gone through all the temptations. He worked with hands. Can a carpenter become a high priest? Never in the history of the Jewish system. Suppose they come to know he was a carpenter until the age of 30, and then all of a sudden you say, I had a call from God saying that you are my beloved son. I have begotten you. Today, just like the coronation of a king, ascension, there was a declaration. Now you have become the heir of my throne. Jesus heard it. When he ascended from the waters of Jordan, he heard a voice from heaven. What was it? This is my beloved son in whom I am well pleased. Remember this evening, this afternoon, all those who are sitting here in the Old Testament or New Testament times, no ladies were called for this type of ministry, but in the 21st century today, some ladies are also called for ministry. See, men and women, God created the person, man and woman, and called their name what? Adam, not Mrs. Eve, but what was their name? God named them as what? Yeah? Adam. Mr. Vijay and Mrs. Vijay. Mr. Johnson and Mrs. Johnson. You lost the Miss title and now you are Mrs. You missed it. Okay. So, it is important. Preparation for the ministry, every department in the world. See, in Kerala or India, anybody can become a barber who can handle the scissor and the, not blade, even if a knife, you can handle, you can be called as a barber. But in US, you have to go to the beauty school and get a training and certificate. How many of the barbers in India got a certificate? No certificate. Preparation is important. Why do certain challenges in the Christian ministry arise? People who were not called or not qualified. Do you agree with me? Yeah? People who are not called by God or not qualified. Come forward. Yeah. Come to the front seats, yeah. So we are happy that you are joining with us, okay? And we are learning, or I am teaching about challenges of Christian ministry and strategies for effective Christian ministry. And the first thing, you also can write down 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verses 1 through 7, and 2 Corinthians chapter 3, verses 7 through 11. And first and foremost, call of God is important. Preparation for the ministry is important. Okay. How many years Jesus was waiting before he entered the ministry? He entered. How many years he spent for ministry? Only three, little over 3 years. Many people say 3.5 years. If you were given such a chance, what would be the age you begin the ministry? At the age of 12, you might have started. He was in the training school. God's appointed time. Jesus came into the world as a savior in the fullness of time. So you, no matter what, I said, Jesus, what was the job he was doing before he entered the ministry? What was the job? He went home. He was obedient to the parents. Usually, he might have been doing the carpentry. So in Jewish system or Jewish history, a carpenter has never become a high priest. Jesus never performed any priestly ministries in the temple. Did he offer any sacrifice? No, because he was not from the Levitical priesthood. Yeah? And also, what type of ministry he only taught? He was teaching, preaching, and also casting out demons. Many other ministries. So I say, no matter what job you are doing now, remember you are going to go to a higher level. How many of you can say amen for that? See, while I am teaching also, I am asking my students once in a while, at least say praise the Lord. Okay? So don't clap your hands always because I did not expect it. And some of our teachers, you know, I am teaching and preaching. So in the Bible college, I started teaching in 1968. So this is the 51st year. So many students were there. They have come there and graduated there and gone. So remember, preparation for the ministry. I also had been to different Bible colleges or seminaries, but you need training no matter whatever you want to do. See, call of God. Then, preparation and call of God for the ministry. Do you have a call? How do you know God called you? Okay, let me share my personal experience. My father was a farmer. Okay? Nobody in our family ever became a teacher or preacher of the word of God. Nobody. I am the first one. So my father wanted me to go to another profession. Okay? Some people call secular or sacred. Each and every job God has given you to handle, that is sacred. Can you say amen for that? Yeah, some people, you may say, no, my hand is devoted to handle the word of God. If some of you, dear sisters, ladies, say, I have a call for the ministry. Okay, let me ask your names. Pastor has mentioned, Pastor, your name? Varki Varghese. And your name?
Moses.
Gifta. Elsie. Binu, Joel, Joelin, Joshua, Monsi, Viji, Liju, Lenish, Edith, Elizabeth, Shalu, Shalom, okay, Shalu. Arpit, okay. And Arpit, Shalu or Elizabeth say, I have a call of God for the ministry and I am studying in the Bible college. So no more I will cook anything. My hand is sacred and devoted for God's work. if you are going to say so, and if Binu is saying such a statement, Pastor Johnson, what will happen to you? Man. So some people say, no, I am fully devoted and committed for the Lord's work, so I will not do any secular work. Whatever your hand finds to do, do it with all your strength. Hard-working persons. Okay, preparation and call. But in that time, there is a call. Call of God. How do you know? I said my father was a farmer. I graduated from the high school with distinction. Then came the voice of God through the word of God. Mark chapter 8, verses 34 following. If anyone comes to if anyone desires to come after me, let him take up his cross and follow me. What will happen, or what is it profitable to a person if he gains the whole world and loses his own soul? And if you are ashamed to witness about me during this wicked and adulterous generation, when the Son of Man comes, he will be also ashamed about them. So nobody talked to me. I received the baptism in the Holy Spirit before that. I was born again, or I committed my life, and I took water baptism only after receiving the baptism in the Holy Spirit. So God's call will come to you through the word of God. Word of God means I am speaking to you today, is it not? I can talk to you. Somebody is recording my words. Okay? You may not see the person, but you can hear the word. Is the presence of God with us this afternoon? How many disciples were with Jesus for the closest training? Only 12. Is it not? How many are here this evening? More than 12. See? Great company. Even when Jesus' master teacher was here, he had a group of only 12 persons. Now, Johnson, you are fortunate. There are more than 12 persons, you know. 12 persons. How in the world, God of the whole world, he took set apart time to module, model, and train only handful of people. Remember, this is precious. I am teaching, or I am preaching to only a small group of people. But you represent how many thousands? You remember how many thousands? Peter, no? Not only in the order of teaching or one by one point. Peter, you were trained for 3.5 years. But remember, when you stood up, by your just one preaching, you were able to win 3,000. How many thousands are sitting before me? Eh? But Viji, or each one of you, Varghese, or Elizabeth. See, there are more powerful ladies than men. You remember? In India, Sonia Gandhi, Mayawati, Sushma Swaraj, when Jayalalitha was there, Jayalalitha, if four of these ladies united, man, they would become the president and prime minister. But the happy thing, they never came together. They never came together. There is power here, you know. Not only women power, man power. So, Jesus took the time for training. Remember, the time you are spending to study the word of God and equipping for the future ministry, you are investing your life for eternity. Don't work for the perishing food, but work for the food that will last until eternity. Preparation, then qualifications for the ministry. What type of a person you want to become? Qualifications. Physical qualification, intellectual qualification, spiritual qualification. Since my time is limited, I am not going to elaborate on that subject. You should read 1 Timothy chapter 3 verses 1 following, okay? 1 Timothy chapter 3 verses 1 following, concerning the bishops or elders and also ministers or deacons, there is given a list of qualifications. What type of a person you should be? In all the qualifications, the core thing or the most important thing is character. Character. Above reproach. If anyone desires to become a bishop or a preacher or teacher, dear sisters and brothers, if you want to, it is a good thing. It is a good thing. But after that comes a list, qualifications. What? Character. He should be able to teach. He should be able to control his family. He should not be a quarrelsome person. He should not be greedy. He should have good reputation and testimony in the community. He should keep faith, the word of God, and his approach, his behavior, not in the home and to the outside world. And there should not be a time or place where Satan can come and accuse you. There should not be pride. Character. So, along with it, where does come the challenge for the ministers? I never wanted to be a preacher. I just started. God called me for the ministry. Looking to some of the ministers or the priest, I came from Marthoma background. You look Catholics or many others or even so-called. We never called ourselves as Pentecostals. It was other people who gave a nickname as Pentecostals. Okay. Pentecostal pastors or Pentecostal workers. In the Old Testament time, there was a dress code, is it not? There was a dress code, not only for the priest, but the high priest and others. And for the Levites, you know, there were certain regulations, strict regulations. What type of dress he should wear and how he should not defile himself by any unholy things. You should be holy, and many of the regulations were given in the Old Testament time for the ministers. Do we need that? Concerning the dress code, no. I am wearing a color shirt. If I was in Kerala preaching to a group of believers there, they will not excommunicate me. But of course, you know, white dress. Nothing wrong with it. But remember, there were certain guidelines. Do we need guidelines? What is the standard? The word of God. Not only the tradition, not only the liturgy, but there should be certain qualifications. Are you qualified? After reading 1 Timothy chapter 3 verses 1 following, you give a self-examination. Okay. You examine yourself. Am I qualified? What is the qualification required for the ministry? This ministry, then remember, some of the challenges, Paul say, we are not like many. What Paul say? Second Corinthians 4 verse 2. We have renounced the hidden things of shame, not walking in craftiness, nor handling the word of God deceitfully. Are there such workers? Look, Second Corinthians chapter 11. 2 Corinthians chapter 11. Paul speaks about certain workers. 2 Corinthians 11. verse 13, for such are, look, false apostles, deceitful workers, transforming themselves into apostles of Christ. Satan himself transforms into an angel of light. Therefore, it is no great thing if his ministers or transformation themselves into ministers of righteousness. What type of workers? Evil workers. False apostles. What is the biggest challenge? It is not the outside attack, Al-Qaeda, RSS, BJP, or any others. That is not the greatest challenge in the Christian ministry. It is what? Counterfeit workers. Their character, is it not? Many of them are making this ministry as a merchandise. Can you say amen for that? Don't make ministry as a job to make money. There were people today, that is a biggest challenge. Yeah? The reason I never wanted to be a preacher or a pastor in the Pentecostal church was there were certain people who brought shame to the gospel of Christ. Is it not? Look to chapter 6. And verse 3, 2 Corinthians 6:3, we give no offense in anything that our ministry may not be blamed. But in all things we commend ourselves as what? Ministers of God in much patience, tribulations, needs, distress, stripes, imprisonment. Remember, if anyone wants to live as a holy child of God, they may face challenges and persecution. People may ridicule you. Nobody in the Jewish community will recruit or call a person who is a fisherman into the priestly ministry. Yeah? How they ever call? Who were John, Peter, James, and many others? Who were they? What were they by profession? Fishermen, you know, fishermen, if they take out the fish with the hand, their hands will be stinging. And you know, the fish merchants in Kerala, their mouth also is stinging. Man, you go to the fishermen and to buy some fish, and they say 1 kilo fish, 55 rupees. And you say, I will not give 55 rupees, I will give only 35. Man, you can hear the sound and the mouth stinging like the rotten fish. They were fishermen. Then how can you handle the word of truth? Okay. So Paul says, we will never give any chance so that the ministry will be offended by your word, by your behavior. By your presence, the name of Jesus should be glorified. Old Testament ministry, Paul makes a comparison of it. Keep your lives clean. Is it not? Keep your life clean. Keep your thoughts clean. Keep your talk clean. And keep your life clean. Holy. How the people in the ministers of God, we call challenges. In the Old Testament times, the prophets were called man of God, woman of God. What does it mean? You represent God. You represent the church. You represent the people of God. When you err or when you make a mistake and when there is certain things that is not consistent with the word of God, you do not bring glory to God, but you bring shame to the gospel of Christ. Paul speaks about such workers. Philippians chapter 3, I am ashamed of them. Their belly, their stomach is their God. Yeah? You see some of the pastors, I don't have that, you know, the development of Madhya Pradesh, you know. Some of the pastors, they have what? They drink all the tea they get, and they eat all the food they get, and no, the outward man is growing, you know. So you have to be very careful. What do you eat and how you eat? Challenges are there. This is a ministry, and then there are challenges. What are some of the challenges? One thing, satanic attacks. See, this is the work of God. The moment Jesus was born into the world, from the time of birth until the resurrection, every time Satan tried to interrupt him, hinder him, attack him. Once he came to tempt him, visible. He can see him, asking questions, if you are the Son of God. When he was born, Herod was tempted to kill all the children. Is it not? Remember, the moment or the day you decided to come for the ministry, I will mention about what types of ministry you will be doing. There may be challenges in your mind, in your body, in your home, in your profession. Every time Satan may tell you, no, go back. Why do you want? Jesus told Peter, many times Satan has asked me to sift you like a. That means you should be blown away. He did not want you to be as a disciple in my group. Why? He knows what is going to an extent the future. If you remain there faithfully, God is going to use you powerfully. Peter was a family man, is he not? He had a mother-in-law. That means what? He had a. So, all those who are married, don't accuse your mother-in-laws, you know. They are gifts of God. So, Jesus healed her. So, family persons, all of you are here, family persons. Is it not? So, is your wife a hindrance for the ministry? Is it a cross God has given to you? No. Or sisters, is your husband a cross which God has given you? No. Family men can also enter the ministry. Say an amen for that. Okay, God called. So, satanic attacks. Every time here, Paul says, you know, many times, Satan hindered me. Satan tried to stop me. When he was talking, when he was teaching, when he was preaching, there were satanic interruptions, witchcraft, sorcery, always. He was there because by preaching the gospel, you are conquering a group of people, capturing them, and bringing them into the kingdom of light. It is I will say, what is the ministry? It is a hard thing. Another thing, one of the challenges in the ministry, as I mentioned, false teachers and prophets. Persons who have no character, who has no reputation. Daniel, what type of a minister was he? We call him Prophet Daniel. But what was his job? He was in the government service. He was the chief over all the governors. Is it not? Whenever there came an account or any of the thing, he was the chief. But in that time, he found time for ministry. You make it as a model. All other people had to give account to the king. But who had to give the final signature? Daniel. Very scrupulous scrutiny. And then he was a minister. What was his ministry? even the empires, even the thrones, he was able to shake them. The command of the king was canceled on account of the prayer of Daniel. There came a verdict, all the wise persons should be what? Beheaded. They should be killed. But the verdict or the command was changed just by one night prayer. There were a group, three others were called. They were kneeling down. Heaven came down. Glory was manifested. So, you might be doing a job, but remember, God has placed you in a situation where nobody can come. Viji or many others who are represented here, Monsi, many others who are represented here, as a pastor or as a minister, I cannot come in your position or place. But God has placed you in a strategic place. How many of you think that God has placed me in a place where I can touch the presence of God? Say a loud amen. You can do better, but this is the starting problem, you know. The starting thing. Okay. So challenges, false workers, satanic attack, and also there are political pressures. Here, political pressures. Is America a free country to preach the gospel? In India, you can set up a PA system, maybe within the radius of 2 miles, and you can preach. Can you set up a PA system like that? No. Why? It is a God's own country. There are political interferences, you know. Even when Daniel was praying, there came, God came down, and angel was sent to give him the reply, but say, the prince of Persia has stopped me for 21 days. See, when you are in the ministry, when you are serving God, there are certain visible enemies and invisible enemies. Satanic attack and things are, what are they? They are invisible. Is it not? Why, you may think, why my prayers are delayed? Why I am fasting and praying, why certain answers come to me? I do not know, but there should come a spiritual revelation from above. But remember, your prayers will be answered. What is another challenge? Your physical means your bodily sickness. That can be a challenge. What does Paul say? There is given to me a thorn in my flesh. So Satan or others did not want or does not want me to further in the ministry. What is the physical challenge you are facing in your life, the day or the time you are serving the Lord? Nobody knows. It may be just like a thorn in the flesh. Yeah? There is a thorn in the flesh and you do not know what is the reason. But remember, hear the voice of God. Yeah? There are challenges. Then another thing can be financial hardships. When a person, especially in the Indian context, enters in the ministry, he has an apprehension, or he is concerned about what would be my future. That was one of the biggest challenges I faced. My parents did not ask me often, but my relatives and friends asked me, you are going to be a preacher. Okay, how much you will get? I can ask Monsi, what is your monthly salary? How much you will get if you become an employee in such a company? How much? But when you become a preacher or teacher in a church, there is no regular salary. Whatever the people gives, whatever they give, you swallow it. And whatever you hear, you follow it. Swallow and follow. That's all. So financial challenges, it's a big challenge. You know that? In the Christian ministry, but happy, I am glad that along with your job, you are doing the work. And when it is time for you to step into a place where Paul was doing and all others, you know, Elijah or Elisha or the disciples, they had been doing certain work, but the day came, the Lord Jesus told, follow me. I will make you fishers of men. Remember, ministry is something is God-given. We have this treasure, we have this ministry, and it is God gave the ministry. You can have all the BD, MDH, DD, and everything. Okay? People can earn their all the titles, but who can give you the ministry? You see the Metropolitan or even the Pope or many others, they have the title. But have you ever seen any persons being saved or healed by the ministry of a Pope? In Malabar, you know, Pastor Johnson knows somewhere in Pulpally area, we went and preached among a group of Catholics. Many were there. And the strong person who was a Catholic, he was questioned by the Catholic priest, why did you call these Pentecostals and gave them the time and also money to preach? And this baby Chan challenged them, asking, even our, can you, if our Pope is here, can he speak in other tongues? And the Catholic priest said, no. He may speak in what? Latin or Rome. One of the Catholic priests, you know, benediction, he did not know much English, you know. You all go in peace. And he said, you may go all in pieces. That's all. Since it was plural, so instead of saying what? You may go in peace. So the Catholic priest in Latin or Roman language say, you may go all in pieces. That's all. This is a ministry. God-given ministry. Challenges are there. Disunity among the workers is a big challenge. Is it a challenge? Disunity in the church or among the workers is a big challenge. Challenge, persons who are not called by God, persons who misrepresent God, an unholy life. Okay? Humanios, Alexander, many of them were like that. So in between, I am going to give you maybe 2-3 minutes to hear your response. What are the other challenges? I said personal, physical lives. From the family, from your community, political, satanic challenges, disunity among the workers. What would be other challenges? Let me hear. You have any questions or any response? What is another challenge? Or few other challenges which I have not mentioned. There are many, but I want to hear from you. Pastor Varghese, what you would say? Any other challenge? Vijay?
Finding time if you are working a secular job.
Yeah. Okay. Finding time to do the Lord's work. Take example of Daniel. He was not a family man, but Vijay has one wife and two children. So that may be a challenge, you know. Finding time to do the work. But in the busy schedule, some way or other, it may not be the hours that counts. Some people say, I am a full-time worker. Say, I would say Assemblies of God, Malayalam District Council. They say, I am a full-time worker, but many are fooling time, you know. They may come to the church on Sunday morning and conclude every services on Sunday. But from Monday through Saturday, they are fooling time, not full time. So, I would not say avoid spending the whole time, but along with your job, the quality time you can spend. Anybody else want to say? Pastor Anjare, I thirarayo. Few more things. I did not say anything about the ministry. What type of, how you can perform the ministry. That also I will mention and then conclude. What are the strategies you can follow? Strategies, one, follow the example of Jesus and also Apostle Paul. Example of Jesus and Apostle Paul. God has given you the ministry. What are you going to do? Romans chapter 12 verses 4 following. Romans chapter 12 and verses 4 following. Would you please stand with me? For as we have many members, let us read together if you have Bible. But as we have many members in one body, but all the members do not have the same function. So, being many are one body in Christ, and individually members of having then gifts differing according to the grace that is given to us, let us use them. Okay? If prophecy, let us prophesy in proportion to our faith, or ministry that is serving, working with the hands. Let us use it in our ministering. He who teaches, in teaching. He who exhorts, in exhortation. He who gives, with liberality. He who leads, with diligence. He who shows mercy, with cheerfulness. What are the different ministries? Paul, 1 Corinthians 12 and 14, are all apostles? No. Are all teachers? No. Are all pastors? No. What is the gift God has given you? You will come to realize what is the gift. Is it personal evangelism? Acts chapter 1 and verse 8. For the ministry, you need divine enablement, or I would say anointing of the Holy Spirit. This is a God-given ministry, and in order to fulfill, what shall we do to do the work of God? This is God's work. All other works, accountancy, medical profession, or whatever it might be, you need only the training and experience to do that work. Is it not? You may not need the anointing or empowering of the Holy Spirit. But remember, Paul says, chapter 2 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 2 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 3, we are walking in the flesh. Though we walk in the flesh, we do not war according to the flesh. For the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but mighty in God, pulling down. See, this is a warfare. You are in a battlefield. You know? How many of you know that? You are in a battlefield. So, what is your ministry? This is a New Testament ministry. Old Testament ministry, it was glorious. New Testament ministry, what is the ministry? First of all, Jesus said, Acts chapter 1 and verse 8, your first ministry is witnessing. Witnessing. You heard the truth. You know the truth. You experienced it. You tasted it. You touched it with your hands. You just tell, as a person who knows Christ, Jesus saved me, he can save you. Okay? What was the ministry Jesus called the disciples? So that they should be with him. Go out, preach. Then, read Luke chapter 9, verses 1 following, what is the ministry Jesus gave to the disciples? And it is in the same fashion you are going to do your ministry. Luke chapter 9, verses 1 following, what is it? Can you display it? Then he called his 12 disciples together and gave them power and authority over few devils. Is there devils in Michigan? Or no devils? All devils, and to cure diseases. Then, the next thing, send them to preach the kingdom of God and to heal the sick. Next, what did Jesus say? Take nothing for your journey, neither staves nor scrip, bread, neither money, neither have two coats. Whatsoever house you enter, abide. That is in the Jewish or Israeli context. Okay? If in USA, okay, one day you go and knock the door of Vijay and say, God commanded me to stay in your house until the day God tells me to go out. Or until the day you tell me to go out, get out. Okay, in the Jewish context, when a stranger or others came, they were giving them bread, water, hospitality. Then, whoever, okay, verse 5, whoever will not receive you when you go out of that city, shake off the very dust from your feet for a testimony against them. They departed and went through the towns, preaching the gospel and healing everywhere. And what happened? 7. Now Herod the tetrarch heard of all that was done by him. He was perplexed. John is risen from the dead. Okay. What are you doing? What is your ministry? Ministry is not only working with the hands. Jesus said, Mark chapter 16, verses 15 following, ministry, go into all the world. Matthew chapter 28, verses 18 following says, go into all the world, preach the gospel. Then, baptize them, teach them, and make them disciples. In the gospel of Mark, it says, you preach the gospel, then you will lay hands, he who is believed and is baptized will be saved. Baptism. These signs will follow them that believe. In my name they shall cast out demons, devils. They shall speak with new tongues. And then they shall take up serpents. And if they drink any deadly thing, it shall not hurt them. They shall lay hands on the sick. They shall recover. The following verses also display it. And the disciples went everywhere. Who was working with them? The Lord was working with them. They went forth, preached everywhere, the Lord working with them and confirming the word with signs. Can it happen today? How many believe it? Say a loud amen. So, when you had a call, when you had a commission, many other things. Jesus told, ask, my Father has sent me, so I send you. You have power and authority, both. Power and authority. You ride through these highways. A small policeman stands there. A 20-wheeler or 30-wheeler truck comes there. Which has the power, you or the truck? Truck. A policeman stands there with a stop sign. Does that truck driver stops it? Why? Authority. Do you have authority? These signs will accompany by the pastors. Is it what it says? No. Can you believe? You are saved by faith. Healed by faith. and you have the assurance God call you, and what is the ministry you are going to do? Okay. All are not pastors. I would say, dear sisters, dear brothers, all of a sudden you need not to become pastor, but remember the person to whom you witness. Sooner or later, he will be convicted of his sin and confess Jesus as his Savior and come to the saving knowledge. What is it? Paul says, I am not ashamed of the gospel. Romans chapter 1 verses 16 following, I am not ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ. What is it? It is the power of God. Dunamis is power in action. It has more power than the powerful dynamite or bomb. You just tell about Jesus, and the word is going to create an awareness of his sin, and it will wash away his sin. It will melt away, and it will destroy all the demonic forces from his life. And you lay hands on that person, and they will be freed, and they will be caught, and they will be captured from the grip of Satan. And a door is open for them to enter to the joys of salvation. This is what happens. So what is your ministry? It is a battle. You have to teach them. It is baptizing them. You lay hands on them. Can you lay hands on them? When a mother, when a sister lays hands on the sister, no? Remember, many of the men may not be permitted in the Muslim or other community to go and lay hands on the ladies. You know that? But can Binu go and pray for a lady? Can you? Can you? We should follow the strategy. What is our strategy technique? The strategy is the same as the first century strategy. You cannot win a community or a person by technology. No matter what suprastructure, what the modern technology you may use, these are all good. But a person can become a child of God only by the blood, washing blood of Jesus. Believe in Jesus. Many people think, you know, your church is not growing, your witness is not effective because why? You don't have these technologies. Is it the lack of technology? No. My brother-in-law and sister, they went to Andhra Pradesh, Vijayawada, to preach the gospel under thatch roof shed. They began to learn Telugu. They began to preach the gospel. Only a handful of people. But now, they are from Kerala. But they began to minister there now on Sundays. More than 18,000 people come for Sunday service. Why? God is working with them. He is performing miracle. Your language is not a barrier. God knows all the languages. When you lay hands on the sick, you need not to have any language. You just lay hands on the sick and pray for them in the language God gives you, and the power is done through the work of God. Do you believe? Let your hands be the hands of Jesus. Let your words be the words of Jesus. Your presence can transform a person. By the very presence of your preaching, you just be here and the devil or evil persons can recognize it. They say, I cannot sit here. I cannot stand here. Here comes a man of God. I know the power is working through him. So the ministry. So you are called, you are being trained, and I will conclude with one or two more things. What is your ministry? Are you aware of the ministry? There are challenges. Strategy, follow, enter through the open way. You tell, how can you win a person to Jesus Christ? All of a sudden, don't tell him you are a sinner, you are going to hell. No. So, you are a sinner. Bible says you are a sinner and you are going to hell. If you want to go to heaven, you believe in me. Don't threaten him like that. Take him as he is. Syrophoenician woman. Who was she? Syrophoenician woman. She came. Jesus, my daughter is sick. She is demon possessed. What did Jesus say? It is not good that the bread should be given to the dogs. If somebody calls you as a dog, what will be your response? Oh Lord, even if my daughter is not healed, I am not going to that pastor again. But she did not give up. She said, Master, even the small dogs eat the crumbs under the table. Jesus said, your faith is great. Was she a born again person? See, miracles will take place when you believe, and that is for a purpose. He may not be a believer. Miracles in the beginning. God performed a miracle in Israel or in Egypt. And then gave manna. After giving manna, that was the beginning of miracle. For the last 40 years, it was showering. God saved you. That is a miracle. God called you. That is a miracle. But you are going to feel and experience the presence of miracle in your daily life when you do the work. Can God strengthen you? And what is the reward of the ministry? It is not only working. Laborer is worthy of his hire. What is the reward you are going to get? You are employed, you are getting money, dollars. But at the same time, satisfaction, the joy, and the privilege to do something for the master. Yeah? Paul was a rich person, many things he done. 2 Timothy chapter 4, verses 6 through 8. I will conclude with that. What is it? I have fought a... He was fighting with whom? Hello? He was fighting with whom? Waging war. Fighting with, not only with the devil, with many other things. I run a good race. Was he an athlete? See, ministry is not only running, not only fighting, but what? By your ministry, he said, God is going to give me a crown. That is the reward, eternal life. Jesus told, what shall we do to do the works of God? Don't work just for the material things. All these crowns, all the glory will fade away. But we have an eternity laid before us. Unfading crown. Glorious ministry. Remember, Paul says in the Old Testament, when Moses was coming down from the mountain, his face was what? Shining with the radiance or with the glory. New Testament, it's a glorious ministry. There is distress, disappointment. Then there is thorn, many other things. But yet, we are conquerors through Jesus Christ. Keep up the call. Don't lose the anointing. Keep eternity in your focus. God has called you. I am going to pray for you. Will you please stand up? No matter what profession you are in, no matter the background you have come in, there may not be a single person who has entered the ministry, who has given ears to the call of God. God has a call upon you. Your ministry may be various. How many of you know that? I will fulfill. I know whom I have believed. And he is able to keep that which I have committed to him until that day. Today, this evening, you commit your life and the talent and whatever God has given in your hand. When you give it into the hand of God, what is it? God is able to guard it. God is able to keep it, and he is going to enable you to fulfill the ministry which the Lord has given to you. Can you say amen for that?